In this video, I'm going to talk about how we can copy text from one array to the other using the concept of character pointers or pointers to a character. I've defined name1 as an array with size 100 and given it the initial message hi:ge/n. So name1 is going to look something like this, hi:ge/n. So if I represent it in memory, hi:ge, the enter character, and this is going to be the null character. Let us say name1 exists at address 1000, I exists at 1001, space at 1002, g at 1003, e at 1004, enter key at 1005, and the null character at 1006. After that, what is there is really not our concern. Name2, let us say it exists at address 2000. So what I have done is I have declared two pointers to a character, ptr1 and ptr2. Right now they are containing random addresses, so immediately in the next step what I am doing is I am assigning ptr1 is equal to name1. So in the variable ptr, the address of name1, which is 1000, is contained. In ptr2, the address of name2, which is 2000, is contained in ptr2. Now just see what I am trying to do here. Now, ptr1 contains the address 1000. When I apply a star to ptr1, it refers to value at address 1000, which happens to be h. So h is definitely not equal to null. So just see what I am doing here. ptr2 is referring to address 2000. Star ptr2 is referring to this particular content. So this particular h is copied into location. This particular h is copied into location 2000. That's what is this statement doing, because ptr1 is at 1000, ptr2 is at 2000. Star refers to value at that particular address. H is copied here. Then I am increasing ptr1 and ptr2. ptr1 is now going to come to 1001. ptr2 is also now going to refer to 2001. So in the 2001 location, before we come there, what is star ptr1? I. It is not equal to null. So this copying happens. So I gets copied here. Then ptr1 and ptr2 get increased. So ptr1 is here, ptr2 is here. Then again, when I go here, I come back to the loop. After I increase this fellow, then this particular space has been copied. Now when I increase ptr1 and ptr2, ptr1 is here, ptr2 is at 2003. So this content G is copied here. Next time E is going to be copied. Then last here you can take the enter key is copied. Okay, enter key gets copied here. Now let's see what happens after the enter key gets copied. After the enter key gets copied, or let's go to the point where the enter key is being referred by ptr1. Location pointed to by ptr1 is equal to enter key. So enter key from here has got copied here in this particular statement. ptr1 is being increased, ptr2 is also being increased. So ptr1 is going here, ptr2 is also come to this 2006 address. But now when I come here, star ptr1 is equal to null. So this while loop fails. But what I have done is I have not copied a null to ptr2. That means I have not put a null at the end of name2. So what I am doing here is ptr2 is 2006. At that particular location, I am putting a null character. And name2 is also going to have hi:ge/n null character. And when I print name2, it is going to print this message hi:ge, the enter key, and the null character is not going to be printed, obviously, because its ASCII value is 0 and it's a non-printable character. So this is how I showed you. You can copy one string to the other using the concept of pointers. So please try to make an effort to understand this by drawing a similar diagram and running through the steps one by one. Because in strings, you will be using pointers extensively, and they are required, and they're really simple and easy to use, provided you understand the basic concept. What you need to do is array1 is at 1000, array2 is at 2000. So ptr1 refers to address 1000, ptr2 refers to at 2000. So ptr1 is referring to 1000, star ptr1 is referring to h. So when I say star PTR1, H is copied here to this star PTR2, which is H. So this way the copying happens. When I'm increasing PTR1 and PTR2, each of PTR1 is going to the next location, PTR2 is also going to the next location. Important step is this null character should be added at the end of this. So automatically name2 is also going to be high space GE backslash N.